In this video, I'm going to be going over the top 5 websites that every web developer should use. And before we get started, make sure they like this video, subscribe, follow me on Instagram. But now, let's get started. Starting off with the first website, which is called Carbon. And what Carbon allows you to do is create images of your source code. So, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to select all of it and then just paste in your code, which I'm not going to do because I don't have it right now. And we can see that I can type here, I can remove code, which means that that does work. And if auto doesn't work for your code, you can just find your language here and then paste it in here. And you can change the font, so if you wanted to, you can change it to VS Code and maybe, I don't know, something else like Material and so on. So I'm just going to keep it at VS Code right now. You can change the background color to whatever you want. So we can see that there's multiple of colors here. You can even set it to an image if you want to. I'm just going to keep it at light blue. And there's a lot of other features like presets. So let's take a look at some of them. So we got the default one. We have, I'm not really sure what their names are, so I can't really talk about them much. But we can also change the window control. So we can see that we can change it to Windows if we want to. So over here. And there's a lot of different things. So editor, we can change the size of it. We can change the line height. For misc, we can use prettify code and so on. So we can see that we can add line numbers and then also hidden characters. And once you're done, all that you're gonna want to do is click on export, and then you can see your image over here. And now you can share your code with other people in a nicer way. Moving on to the next website, which is called codepen.io, which is an online coding editor, and we can see that it's used to build and test, learn and discover, and share your work. So build and test, so just basically writing small code and then testing if that works, and then after you perfect that, you can add that to your own website. Learn and discover, so you can see what other people made, and then you can share your work. So we can see that there's some work that other people made in here. If we scroll up, we can search up stuff like, let's say, navbar and see how other people made it, and then copy that and then paste that to your own website. But obviously, you're gonna wanna change that a bit. So let's take a look at this example. We're gonna be able to see some stats. So this is basically likes, comments, and then we can see that it has 264,000 views. And then we just. And so we can see that we have the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript at the very top here. Test this. So if we click on different links, we can see that it's going to work. We can see all of the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript code in here, and we can copy it. Let's actually go back, and we can click on start coding in here, and we can start from scratch. So let's say that I want to create an element. I'm going to create an H1, and then I'm going to write some text in here. So, hello world. We have to wait a bit. And then there's our element in here. We can select it in the CSS. Let's change the color to purple. And then we can also change the font size. So font size to, let's say, 20 rem to make it a lot larger. So there it is. We can also add some JavaScript, which I'm not going to do right now, but you get the point. But then the perk of being logged in is you can save this and then access it on another devices. So you can even access it on your phone and work on it if you want to. But it's not going to be as good because it's obviously going to be a lot harder to be typing it on your phone keyboard. Moving on to the next website, which is called draw.io or app.diagrams.net. I'm going to click on decide later. And what it is a design tool for your website. And so here you can plan out your website's layout. So let's actually go ahead and add a nav bar. I'm going to put the nav bar over here. Let's make it longer. And we can change the color to something like, I don't know, let's say green. We can add a, let's say right here, we're going to have an image. So I'm going to make this larger. So this big, and let's say we wanted some text. I'm gonna write text in here, and we can add this text element like that. We can change it, make it larger, and so on. So if we go to misc, we're gonna be able to add tables. So let's add a table here and a lot of other tools. So in advanced, we have more stuff, so we can add lists. Let's make it larger. We can add a lot of other elements, so arrows. We have flowcharts, and the best part about it is that this is free and you can share with other people, and there's a whole bunch of other options that I haven't went over, so make sure that you check it out. Moving on to the next website, which is called smalldev.tools, and over here you're gonna have access to a lot of small tools. So here, generate credit card test data, we can decode URL, we can generate a QR code, and so on. So let's actually take a look at one of them. Let's go to the QR code generator. So here in the QR code content, what you're gonna want to do is you're just gonna want to write something. So let's write "Hello World." And then for the title, I'm gonna write test. Subtitle, you can also write something. And if we actually click on generate, we're gonna see this QR code. And if you actually scan it, what you're gonna see is the text in the QR code content. So if you put a URL in here, let's for example take the URL of this website and put it in here. And then I'm gonna write DevTools. And I'm gonna actually write small dev tools, and let's say we want to change the color to something else. Let's do green, so I'm just gonna pick this color. And now if you scan this with your phone, you're gonna be able to open this website, and this is only one of the tools out of many. So let's go back here and let's take a look at another tool. So let's say CSS compressor, which, and I don't have CSS on me right now, so I'm just gonna write something really fast. Let's do H1, and all that we're gonna do is just gonna change the color to, let's say, dark. But if we press on compress CSS, we can see that it compressed it, and we can see that all of these other tools are going to be also really useful. Moving on to the next website, which is remove.bg, and this is also pretty self-explanatory. So if you need to remove the background of an image that you want to put on your website, this is going to be the website that you're going to want to use. So I'm going to upload an image. I'm going to choose the image that we used in Carbon. So I'm going to upload it in here. And now we just need to wait. And we can see that it removed the background of that image. And we can even edit it. So we can go back and we can see that they have a bunch of different cool backgrounds that we can use. And we can erase or restore. And now moving on to the last website, which is called Flaticon.com. And this is a website that I personally use because it has access to over 12 million vector icons and stickers. So let's go ahead and search up computer and take a look at some of the examples here. So we can see that there is going to be 388,000 different computer icons. So let's say that I like this icon, I would click on it. And we can see that there's going to be three different options, and not all of the icons have it. It depends on the person who made them. So we can see that there's just black, black and white, and then one with colors. So let's scroll down, and let's say I like this one. We can see that there's the default one, there's one with border, and then a black and white one. So, like I said before, it really depends on the person who made them. But now let's say that I like this one. And I would want to copy to my clipboard. All I would have to do is click on the copy PNG, and now we can see that it's going to be copied to my clipboard. But the only downside is that if we click on PNG here, we can see that we do need a premium subscription, but we are web developers, which means that we should figure out how we can get it without the premium subscription. Or what you can do is copy it to your clipboard and then paste it, let's say, on Photoshop and then use it there. So that's the only downside that this website has, but it does have a bunch of different varieties of icons and everything else. And so this is gonna be for this video. So I really hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, then make sure to leave a like, subscribe, follow me on Instagram, and hopefully see you in the next video.